Today, I am going to explain why furries are not into bestiality because they are attracted to anthropomorphic animal characters. So, yes, it's kind of weird that they're animals, human characteristics, which means, what are they trying to do? Make it okay to have an attraction to these characters even though they're animals? No, I think it's, if they make them attractive, it's for a reason to attract a certain kind of audience, such as furries. Because us furries are anthropomorphic animal characters ourselves. And our furry selves, our fursonas, are the ones that get attracted to the characters that are animals, that talk, walk on 2 feet, or have human characteristics other than that. So, therefore, I lost my train of thought. Oh my god. What was I saying? Oh my god. Okay, our personas, our furry selves, are inside animals. Not like theory and stuff. I mean, like, the part of us that likes to dress in our furry characters or draw our furry characters are the part that gets attracted to these anthropomorphic, which means human characteristics, not just an ordinary animal. That would be bestiality if it was just a regular animal. It's still bestiality if it's like Air Bud or whatever, because they're real dogs with CGI moving mouths. So that's weird. I got fur in my mouth. Okay, just spit in my suit, you. Shouldn't have done that. That was a bad idea. Okay, well, anyways. Some people have ruined the fandom for other people because they actually are into bestiality. That's not who we are. So, anyone like that, screw off, because you're disgusting. Yes, they make anthropomorphic animals look sexy, like Lola Bunny in the Bugs Bunny cartoons. So, yeah, a lot of Disney characters are like that too. I don't know if they're trying to attract us furries, but they're trying to attract somebody. I hope they're not trying to attract zoophiles. I'm pretty sure not, but that's not what it's about, so